Welcome back to another one, guys. We are doing something a little different today. We're going to be doing a little bit of pond hopping. Now, if they're biting here, there'll be no hopping. It'll just be ponding. Ponding, is that a word? It has been a while since we've been to the pond. Looking like it's pretty stained, but we'll see if we can make something happen. Today we're throwing a 3/8 ounce spinner bait with a willow leaf and a small Colorado blade. So let's see if we can make something happen here. Hit right off the bat. I didn't even feel like that. Oh, he got off. Oh, no, he's still here. Oh, there he is. Oh, he came back for it. He came back. Oh, that is a big fish. Oh, right off the bat. Second cast. That is a nice, nice bass. Get him in here. Easy, fella, easy. Come on, come on, come on. I'll let you go. I'll let you go. I'll let you go. This guy's not too happy at the moment. That's okay. I got you. I got you. Look at that. Second cast. That is a huge bass. Huge. Did I say huge? All right, buddy. Here you go. Second cast. Now, I don't doubt for a second I've caught that fish before. And the reason being was I threw it right down there along the bank, and I've caught fish that size numerous times down there. Now, keep in mind, there's a lot of big fish in here, so maybe it isn't the same one, but I'm going out on a limb and saying it is. That guy nailed that as soon as it hit the water. I'm gonna go for a walk around here, and we're gonna come in under the shade over there and see if there's anything in there. Well, the other end looked like it had some poison ivy on it. In it, near it, by it, something like that. And I'm not 100% certain, but I'm not interested. So we'll come down to this end. This end here will usually produce some fish, so we'll see what happens here. Camera just caught that, but something just came up and hit that right at the shoreline. There we go. We got you that time, fella. Little guy. Good to see the little ones in here too. Thanks for the second chance. Oh, he hit that right in the weeds. Right in the weeds. Very nice. Very nice. A little bit bigger, but not as big as the first. So I just slowed that one right through the, well, you can't see where I'm pointing. I just slowed that one right through the front of the weeds here. It popped out of the water a couple of times. Through there, and he didn't hit the weeds, which will also grab some attention. Must have been by himself. Let's go back to this corner down here. Now before we go to the corner, let's run this bank right here. That's a big hit. Oh yeah, nice, nice. Always check your shorelines. A little bit bigger, not as big as the first. I think I already said that once. Thank you. No commitment issues on that guy at all. I'm going to run this one right through the Phragmites here. No dice. Oh, that was a swipe. At it again. Okay, so I don't know if you guys can see it. There's some rocks in the bottom here. There's also a long rock that comes out here. He's hitting right at the tip of that. Twice. My guess is he's not very big. I get to that rock right there, let it drop. And of course, he doesn't hit it that time. That was a pretty good hit there. Oh, there you go. He came back. He came back. No commitment issues on this guy. This little guy was hungry. He wanted some. He smacked it once and said, "It tastes good, I'll take it again." That did not come out right, did it? So that's two off of this one spot right here. About 5 feet off of the edge of this weed line. Or that piece of wood and metal, or that piece of metal sticking up there. Oh, come on. Oh, he let go. He let go. He smacked that a ton. Well, let's see if we get second chances here. That was a big fish. That was big. I gotta get a better hook set on them. That's the problem. That is the problem. I don't know that there's going to be any second chances here. We needed that guy. We needed him. If you look right out there, there's a whole bunch of bait fish jumping. They're being chased by something. We're gonna throw past them and see what's going on, if anything. Who knows? My guess is the bass are chasing them, but every time I cast into a pile like that or past a pile like that, I don't catch anything. So I'm not sure what it is, chasing them or they're just jumping on their own. There we go. I saw him jump. Really good to see these small fish in here. Really good to see them. That means it's populating well. They're not just giant bass eating all the bait fish. So that's good to see. Look at my reel. The thumb just broke off here. Abu Garcia, what's up with that? Wonder if you can buy just the plastic piece or do I gotta buy a whole new reel? I really hate to give this corner up. It's got some really good potential in it. See, a guy jumped over here. Now I go walking back over here. To see if he's just out for fun. Or he's hungry. He was just jumping because he can. I'm gonna try and get to that shade spot over there if I can. Well, not the shade spot I wanted, but we're gonna give this a try. Nothing here. Well, we made it back to where we started, where that big 5 or 6 pounder was caught. See if there's more than just him here. Well, guys, I think we're gonna call it there. This is our pond hopping without the hop. I said, if this pond produces, we're not leaving, and it sure did produce. Anyway, that's all I got for today's video. Hope you all enjoyed that. And get outside and enjoy some sunshine. See you all in the next one. Later.